as some of you know, this is my first St. Patrick's Day as Irish Ambassador to the United States. And I have to tell you, it's not even St. Patrick's Day yet. We have 3 days of festivities to go. But today has been extraordinary. It has been really, I think, an unimaginable experience. And I'm certainly on a high, and I think the whole of the delegation is on a high. Washington has truly opened its arms to us today. Throughout the day, from the breakfast we had with the Vice President, the meeting in the Oval Office, the Speaker's lunch, and the partying in the White House, and now here this evening, it has been an amazing day, with speeches that were witty and heartfelt and inspirational, and it has really been the best kind of celebration, because it has been celebration with substance. We covered a huge amount of ground, and we've had a great time in the course of the day, so it's been a wonderful day. And I just don't know, as I say, 3 days to go, but I don't know how this will be matched, so it's wonderful. One last thing about the Taoiseach. This is a man of the most extraordinary stamina. Some of you may know he has climbed Croagh Patrick in Ireland, our holy mountain. He has climbed it over 100 times. He has even climbed Kilimanjaro, I'm told. He's done hill cycling, hill walking, the end of the day, folks. Maybe he's done hill cycling for all I know. Cycling and hill walking and all of that. So I actually learned one thing from this first experience of St. Patrick's Day. In preparation for next year, when the Taoiseach comes back, I'm not going to bother poring over the files or anything like that. I'm going to say to everybody in the embassy, we need to go to some kind of a boot camp for fitness training to keep up with this man.
I say that it's a privilege to be here in America and in Washington. Ambassador, thank you for your introduction. As somebody said before, kind of a bit over the top in a way. Admiral Crowell, I remember when he was introduced here in Washington, said, "God, I wish my parents were here. My father would have liked it, and worse still, my mother would have believed it." Immigration was in the DNA of the people, and yet those who left because of economic circumstances and whatever were never afraid to roll up their sleeves and face whatever challenges came their way. And that's the motivation that we have to harness as a people, not just in Ireland, not just in America, those who are Irish, but around the world. And we have that capacity now with our 70 million people being able to be connected together with the new digital facilities that we have, and make them understand that the national challenge we have at home is to prove that yet again the Irish can deal with the challenges that we face as part of the European Union. Upstate Connecticut, or upstate New York, or wherever, in between, our Irishness is the common thread that we have here. And those connectors go into so many places, from the cleaners to the presidents and the chief executives of companies. There are Irish people in there. We need to harness that optimism, we need to harness that productivity, we need to harness that motivation. And when we do, nothing can stop us. In fact, nothing will stop us. And we get all of those people around the world moving in everybody's interests, not only to make our own country great, but to build others by sending out a message. Here is an old country, a small country, but it's got heart, it's got soul, it's got courage, And for my time, with my remit, I'm very happy to lead that and to say send out that message around the world. And I walked down the main street of the road in Chicago 2 years ago with Rahm Emanuel. He said, look at all these people in green t-shirts, Mexicans, everybody. They all wanted to be Irish. It's a privilege to be here. Have a great evening. I'm looking forward to the dancers here. What school are you from? What's the dancer?
Academy.
Well, they're going to give us a display here like none ever seen before.